So it's time to learn some Linux commands. Let me write them on the board with a short explanation, after which we can go to the console so that I can show them. First command that I want you to know about is who am I? Not because it's so important, but because it's an easy command and you can probably guess what it is doing. Then we have the hostname command. Another one of these commands that probably you know what it's going to do. That's right, showing the name of the current host. The date command allows you to show current date and time, and you can even use it to set the current date and time. Then there is uname. Uname is an interesting command because it's going to give you some information about your system, about the kernel in particular. And you can see information such as kernel version and kernel build and platform. Then we have passwd or password, which is the command that allows you to manage passwords. The touch command is an easy command that allows you to write files, which are empty files. So touch is very useful to verify that you can write to a file system. And as the last command, there's last. And that is going to show you a list of users that have logged into your system last. Let's wait no longer. Let me show you how to use these commands. To start with, there's who am I. If you type who am I, you see who you are. This is your current username. And my username happens to be user, so I am user. Now on Linux, almost all commands work with --help as an argument. And if you use --help as an argument, it is telling you how to use the command. So we can work with two options, --help and --version. It's not very useful, but who am I --version is showing the current version of the utility. Congratulations, you have just become familiar with your first utility on Linux. Now let me use a Ctrl L key sequence, which is a default key sequence that will always work in a bash shell. Bash is the command interpreter that we are currently using, and Ctrl L is clearing the screen. And now let me type the second command, which is hostname, which is showing me the current name of this host. And guess what? If you use hostname --help, you can see that, wow, this command works with a lot of options. So many options that it doesn't fit on the screen. Now this is a graphical screen, so it's easy to scroll up. But if you are on a command line, it's not easy to scroll up. And you need to figure out another solution to be able to read the output of the command. In Linux, we do that by using a pipe. So this is the character for the pipe. And after the pipe, we use the command less. Less is a pager, which allows us to see the output of the command page by page. And I can use arrow keys or the spacebar to scroll down, and in less you can even scroll up. And you can see that this command has a lot of options. Also notice that this option, for example, the highlighted one, there's uppercase A. That's an uppercase. Here we see there's lowercase a. In Linux, case matters. So don't try to type your commands or your command line options in uppercase if really it must be a lowercase, because Linux won't understand. Also, you can see in these options that the option has a short alternative and a long version. So you can type --a as well as --aliases. Or --uppercase I as well as --all IP addresses. Wow, all IP addresses, that's a lot of typing. But the idea of the long options is that these are human intuitive options. So let me use Q to get out of here. And let's use hostname --all IP addresses, which is showing all IP addresses currently in use by this host. Let's have a look at the next command, which would be date. And what is that doing? Date is showing the current date and time. Notice that it's not only the date and time, but also the current time zone, PST, and the year as well. And as you have guessed, the date command also has a --help. And you know what? I'm already sending it to a pipe because I'm expecting a lot of output. I don't want to talk about all the output here, I just want to make the point that sometimes the output provided by --help is a lot. Let me use Q to get out of the less viewer again, so that we can talk about passwd. Passwd, you probably can guess what it is. It's for setting a password. And if I type it without any arguments, then it is allowing me to change my current password. In order to do so, I need to start by typing my password, and then I can type another password. And oh no, the password is the same as the old one, but I want to use the same password as the old one. Fortunately, password command is sending me to you have exhausted the maximum number of retry for services. Now, if you type passwd minus minus help, then you can see something interesting, and that is that passwd can be used on an account name. And if you use it on an account name, it means that you can set the password for another user account. Really? Is that going to work? Let's try. Passwd root. Ah, only root can specify a user name. So up to now we've been working as an ordinary user. For some tasks you need to be a root. The easiest way to get access to an environment where you are root is by typing su minus. Su is for switch user. And optionally you can type the name of the user that you want to switch to behind the su command. If you don't type the name of a user, you are going to switch to the root account. The minus means open a login shell. In a login shell, the full environment of the target user will be set. And that's exactly what I want. And that's why basically I always use su minus. It's asking for a password, and as I haven't provided a username, I need to enter the password for user root. Look, you can see at the current prompt that I'm logged in as user root on a machine called CentOS, and we are in tilde, which is the current directory. We'll talk more about that later. And now if I'm typing passwd user, then you can see that root can easily change the password for user user. That sounds a little bit redundant, but that's the way it is if the name of your user is user. You can also notice that if the user wants to change his password, he first needs to enter the old password. If root wants to change the password, that's not necessary. The root user just needs to type the new password. And even if the password fails the dictionary check, root can do it. That's because root is kind of an almighty user who can do whatever he wants to do. Now it's a good habit if you are currently working as root to type exit to get out of the root shell. Next command that I want to show you is touch. Touch is a useful command. It allows you to verify that you can write. Look, I type touch hello and I get nothing in return. That's how Linux normally works. Commands are successful, you don't get any confirmation. The command just works. If it's not successful, it will start complaining. If I type the ls command, you can see that the file with the name hello has been created. You use touch to create an empty file, and that is just useful to verify that you can write. If I type cd slash, which will bring me to the root of the file system, and I type touch hello again, then you can see at this point I'm getting permission denied. And that's for the simple reason that an ordinary user cannot write everywhere. Let's get back to my home directory by using cd without anything behind it. You don't have to specify the name of the directory. If you only type cd, it will always bring you to your home directory. And as the last command that I want to show you, I can type last. And what is last showing you? Last is showing you the last logins that have happened on this system. Now with this, at least you have experience with seven commands on Linux. You know, it makes sense if you talk about systems like man and stuff, if at least you know a little bit about using commands. But before we move on and talk about man, we need to check one command on Ubuntu. So hang on as I switch to my Ubuntu machine, and we'll talk about the password command on Ubuntu. There's one thing that we need to do on Ubuntu. You remember on CentOS I typed su minus. Su minus doesn't work on Ubuntu because su minus prompts for the root password, and on Ubuntu for security reasons the root user doesn't have a password. On Ubuntu, the alternative is sudo minus I. While you install Ubuntu, you create a default user. And this default user by default gets administrator privileges. And as a default user, you can open a root shell using sudo minus I. The difference is that sudo minus I is going to prompt for the password of your current user account. So here we go. You see I'm being prompted for the password for user. So I'm typing the password and then I have access to the root shell. So if I wanted to use passwd user, for example, I need a root shell. There we go. And for the rest you can see that the command is quite similar. The output is a little bit different, but that's something that you will that you will see more than once. The commands are more or less the same, but the way the commands react, the way they provide feedback may be different between the different Linux distributions. So now I have reset my password using the root account. I can type exit to get out of the root shell. There's another way that I might have used, and that is by using sudo followed by the command that I want to run as root, which in fact is the more elegant way. Sudo password means basically run the password command as user root, and it will prompt for the user root password. So it's asking for the new user, the new Unix password. Did you see that? It didn't even ask me for the password of user. That is because I recently have used the sudo command. So the password is still cached. That is to avoid that you need to type the password for every single sudo command that you are going to use. So I'm typing my new password, I'm doing that twice, and then I'm getting back to my user prompt. The who am I command is showing that I'm still user, but still using sudo passwd, I have used this one single command with root privileges.